Welcome back. Today we will discuss some Neet MDS questions. First one, a prepared cavity is best protected from moisture by A. cotton roll, B. saliva ejector, C. rubber dam and D. paper napkins. Answer is option C. rubber dam. Among cotton roll, saliva ejector, rubber dam and paper napkins, the best recommended for moisture control is rubber dam. Going to second one. Smear layer consists of A. enamel debris, B. microorganism, C. dentinal chips and D. all of the above. Answer is D. all of the above. Smear layer is nothing but it's a microcrystalline debris that is embedded in denatured collagen on the cut surface of the tooth. It's almost 1 to 2 millimeter in thickness and it consists of saliva, bacteria, enamel and dentinal particles. Smear layer debris pushed into the dentinal tubules is known as smear plug. Smear layer plus smear plug, it consists of, it forms smear unit. So, the answer for this is all of the above. Third one, incipient caries consists of opaque chalky white areas that appear when the tooth surface is dried. This is referred as A. white spot, B. hot spot, C. translucent zone, D. body of lesion. Answer is option A. white spot. Next question, a butt joint is a, option A 90 degree joint, option B 120 degree joint, option C 70 degree joint and option D 180 degree joint. Answer is option A 90 degree joint. In butt joint, the cavo surface angle is 90 degree. Cavo surface angle is nothing but as angle at the junction of the walls of the cavity preparation and external surface of the tooth. That is cavo surface angle. And this butt joint, it is advocated mainly in amalgam restoration. Also advocated in silicate and porcelain restoration. Next question. Deepening the pulpal floor during cavity preparation provides for A. outline form, B. retention form, C. convenience form and D. resistance form. Answer is option D, resistance form. Resistance form is obtained by relatively flat pulpal and gingival floor and also box shape. Then internal line angle should be rounded. Then advocate thickness of the restorative material. Then inclusion of weakened tooth structure and reduction of cusp for capping whenever indicated. So these are the features of resistance form. By deepening the pulpal floor during cavity preparation, it increases the resistance form by increasing the bulk of restoration. Next one, intercuspal width ideally for class 2 amalgam cavity should be 1 by 2, 1 by 3, 1 by 7 and 1 by 5. Answer is option D, 1 by 5. Going to next question. What is common in class 1 cavity preparation for amalgam and gold inlay? A. buccogingivally divergent valves. B. mesiodistally divergent valves. C. maximum depth is needed in both areas to provide sufficient thickness. And D. all of the above. Answer is option B. mesiodistally divergent valves. Fifth one. The retention for class 5 restoration are placed A. in mesial and distal areas, B. occlusal and gingival areas, C. in all except the axial walls and D. at expense of axial walls. Answer is option B. occlusal and gingival areas. According to G.V. Black's classification, class 5 is known as restorations on the gingival third of the facial or lingual surface of all teeth. So, retention is provided in the occlusal and gingival areas, whereas in class 2 tooth preparation, the location of retention grooves are located in the buccoaxial and lingoaxial line angles. For class 3, it is located in the axiogingival line angles. For class 5, it is occlusal and gingival axial line angles. So the answer is option B, occlusal and gingival areas. Ninth one, the function of proximal grooves in a class 2 cavity is A, resistance form, B, retention form, C, increases the strength, and D, resistance and retention form. Answer is option D, resistance and retention form. The features that enhances the retention form also enhances the resistance form. So, retention lock, grooves, slot, pin, groove extension and skirt, these increases both retention and resistance form. This is according to Sturdivant. It's mentioned in the Sturdivant 5th edition. Next question. In an ideal restoration, gingival margin should be below contact point but 1 mm occlusal to gingival crest. Option B, below contact point but at the level of gingival crest. Option C, below gingival crest. And D, at the contact point. Answer is option A, below contact point but 1 mm occlusal to the gingival crest.
Thank you for watching this video. Please do like, share and subscribe. Thank you.